always known about electricity. Just think of a lightning bolt. And we know about magnets and how they attract and repel. Now, meet Michael Faraday, one of the greatest superstars of science. His work on the relationship between electricity and magnets led directly to the electric motor and the electric generator, things that have transformed the way we live today. No wonder he's known as the father of electricity. Check him out. Faraday was born on the 22nd of September, 1791, and grew up in a poor but God-fearing family just outside London in Newington Butts. Although he'd be well over 200 years old by now, the impact of his life is still with us. His father, James, was a simple blacksmith from Yorkshire who moved his family south to London in search of work. They lived above a coach house full of horses with Michael's brother, Robert, and sister, Margaret. Faraday didn't get much of an education and finished school at just 13. A year later, he became an apprentice to Mr. Rebo, a local bookbinder and bookseller. This was a key move. In his 7 years with Mr. Rebo, he got to read a lot of books, which was unusual for poor kids back then. One of his favorites was Conversations on Chemistry, a sort of chemistry for dummies. All this reading made Faraday want to find out more and more. That's why he would often go to lectures at the Royal Institution given by the celebrity scientist, Sir Humphrey Davy. Michael was so super keen not to miss a thing that he made tons of notes. Then he had the nerve to bind them into a book and send them to Sir Humphrey. Sir Humphrey was so impressed with this young man that when one of his chemistry experiments went wrong and he damaged his eyesight, he decided to hire Faraday as his assistant. What a major break! Faraday now had his dream job, where he could learn everything from this great scientist. The only snag was his wife, Lady Davy. She was a right old snob and treated Michael like a servant, sneering and looking down on this poor boy from a simple background. Bet she'd feel pretty stupid now. All this learning had filled Faraday's brain with new theories. Soon, he got down to testing his ideas about electricity and magnets with his own experiments. One of the most famous took place in 1821. It's about electromagnetic rotation, and you could say it was the first electric motor. So, what did he do? He got two glass jars and filled them with liquid mercury, because it's an excellent conductor of electricity. Then he put a magnet in each jar. Next, he hung a wire into the glass jars. He sent an electrical current through the wire, and hey, the wire started to turn around the magnet. When he did the opposite and held the wire still, the magnet turned. By doing this, Faraday showed you can transform electrical energy into mechanical energy. Very handy. This experiment was the ancestor of the electric motor. Super excited by this success, Faraday carried on experimenting like crazy. After 10 long years, how many experiments is that? He made his most famous discovery in 1831, known as electromagnetic induction, which loosely translated means electricity, magnet, bring it on. Can a magnet actually produce electricity? Faraday discovered that it could. If you could move a magnet in and out of a wire coil, you can create or induce an electric current in the wire. Massive discovery! The superhero scientist Einstein had a picture of Michael Faraday on the wall of his study, which tells you something about the guy's status. And Faraday's influence stretches far and wide in today's world. What's great to remember in the 19th century, when exploring science was just for rich, educated toffs, Faraday proved that a self-taught, self-motivated person who worked hard and kept going could make it right to the top. So next time you flick a switch, say, "Hey, thank you, Michael Faraday."